Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reddy from Palmerstown, USA, Jonelle Allen. McLean Stevenson. And Deborah Lee Scott. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of that game, Gene Rivers.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. What
a throng. Is there a hurricane
throng.
Or what?
Yes. No, listen, you look very elegant, stars. I greet you.
I want to know where she bought her outfit. Where did you buy your outfit?
J.C. Penney's.
No.
Newberry's?
A wonderful place in Laguna Beach where I live.
Okay, yes. That's enough of that. No plug. Let's say hello to Sherry Karmaz and Ralph Webster.
Why not?
Hello. Now, where are we? In the first game, right? And we're going to go to round number two. Ralph, would you quickly relate the events of your life to this point?
I was born, I grew up in Massachusetts, and I've traveled around a lot. I'm a geologist. I have a lot of interests, one of which is traveling, and the rest range from metaphysics to massage and mountaineering.
Well, he's an all-around kid, isn't he? Now, Sherry, tell us about you.
I'm a native Southern Californian. I've lived here most of my life. I work for a major airline in their air cargo department.
You don't handle a cargo.
No, I don't. I'm also a part-time student.
All right. Good luck to both of you. We're in round two. He's ahead, 4-1. And since you're ahead, you have to go first, Ralph.
We'll go with B again.
B again. Two people play, Brett and McLean, the two intellects on the show.
Wonderful.
Little Rodney Rich is really rich.
How rich is he?
Well, he's got the only rocking horse in the world with a blank. That's how rich he is.
Everything's swell. You want my answer, McLean?
Wait a minute. There we go.
That's there
sort
we
of
go.
Cute.
Now, Ralph, little Rodney Rich is really rich. He's got the only rocking horse in the world with a blank.
With a Rolls Royce.
Wrong.
I think you blew it, Ralph.
Could be.
What do you say, Brett?
I'm so thrilled when I get the joke, you know, because I don't always get the joke. I'm so thrilled. I'm so happy with myself. Please read the question. I don't ask you to do this. Okay, go, baby.
He's got the only rocking horse in
You're
the world with a...
In.
Jockey!
Jockey, yay!
I'm always so thrilled to have
Are you thrilled?
I'm just glad to be any place.
Yes, no, I really am. It's been a wonderful week for me, sitting between the two ladies, talking about where'd you get the shoes, where'd you get the shoes.
And you wouldn't tell us.
That's because you
were... talking about you, too. However, rolling right along. My Lord, that looks... Is that... What is that?
Well, they did that because you could... This ink bleeds through, and you could read the answer from the other side.
No, I just...
Now, just look at that. You can read the answer from the other side, can't you? What's it say?
Yes. I was just looking at this thing of what it's doing
to my face.
The
pattern, yes.
Well, I just haven't had a drink in 4 years and thought I had and didn't know it. I put down a jockey.
You did indeed. All right. So. Now, Sherry, the way it is, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Loose
I got her, too. I know, right.
Right.
Could I not eat with the other patients?
Hey, no kidding.
What?
Nobody should drink in the middle of the day.
No.
Just a tip for you housewives out there. Laying flat on the carpet if you've got fuzz on your mirror. It's the show, folks.
Here we go now. Listen carefully. Lou said, my wife likes to fight so much.
Me too.
Waiter, could I have the check, please?
Brett, you lay out this round.
He's always laying out.
Lou said...
What did he say?
My wife likes to fight so much, our marriage counselor is blank. Our marriage counselor is blank. There it is. All right, here we go. My wife likes to fight so much, our marriage counselor is...
A referee.
A referee is very good. Good response, right?
Yeah.
You don't have it.
How did you know?
I can tell by the look on your
face. The expression on my face gives away that I did not say referee.
Right.
No, I said our marriage counselor is Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. What do you say, Charles?
Thank you.
I don't know all the sports terms.
Well, there's a referee in a ring with a fight. You know that.
No, I'm sorry. I said referee.
A referee.
He can change the thing around with it.
Yeah. Score is now 4-2. Jonelle.
I'm with Bill. I said Muhammad Ali. If you're going to fight, you better have him in your corner.
Have you noticed how many answers she and I have had alike this week?
That's right.
Because he cheats.
You look over your shoulder.
In the back of her head.
What do you have, McLean?
I'll have cheeseburger, banana daiquiri, and fries.
Okay. All right.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Coming up in a minute.
You have not had one right, so let's get ready with the big... I said punch drunk.
Punch drunk. Now, Sherry, we're going to wheel you off for just a little while. We'll come back to game number two later. Bye.
Bye, Sherry.
Now, here we go with the big money here. Good luck to you, sir. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said write down your best answer to this. The blank bomb. You know how the money goes? Let's see who you'd like to call on for a little help.
How about Bill? The atom bomb.
All right, there's one.
How about Brett?
The time bomb.
All right.
Good. How about McLean?
Listen, I'll get right back to you, okay?
wait, here.
Yes, I do, frankly. I didn't even hear the question. Wait. I'm sorry.
It's up here.
Okay, I know what it is. All right.
Here, this.
I know, don't...
Not the big bad. Bomb.
The...
It's a joke.
Oh, come on.
No, wait a minute. This is serious.
Okay. And we've got the A-bomb. Do we have the H-bomb?
We have the A-bomb. We haven't got the H-bomb.
I didn't think we did. Carter's been lying all this time. Do we have the atomic bomb? We do. I'm sorry to take this much time, but my show has been canceled, and God, I love it. I will say the time bomb.
That was sad.
We said that already.
Well, I thought so. Okay. I'll say the big bomb from what I'm doing now. Thank you.
The big
you
bomb?
Know.
Big bomb. The big bomb.
Just turn around and S Fuzz face. I don't put it on anymore.
So the big bomb, the time bomb, and the atom bomb are the three. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I like the atom bomb.
Yeah. All right, the atom bomb is what he wants. Let's find out if it's under the one.
I don't like it. That's the answer.
Right. Let's take a look at the $100 response. The time bomb is there. All right, yay yourself. Let's take a look at the next one. The nude bomb.
Oh, that was with, what's his spot?
Ira, what is that?
That movie.
Don Adams movie.
Don Adams, of course,
my
favorite.
Yeah, another turkey, friends.
Moving that bomb, if you will.
All right, let's take a look at the top one, if you please. Yay! Ralph, the minimum you'll play for is $5,000, but spin the wheel, see if you can make a $10,000. Here we go. What you're playing for. Face me if you would, please, sir. Good luck to you. Ready? Here we go. Steak and blank. Steak and blank. You want to take a look at it? All right.
How much do they have to play that guitar player? Is that much? I suppose it is. 20 seconds. Blank, blank. That plays the same song. Listen.
No.
All right, now, if you give us the answer that matches Bill Anderson, you get $10,000. What do you say?
Steak and eggs?
Steak and eggs.
You'll get it.
I don't know. He lives on a farm outside of Nashville, and that may be a very popular dish there. I don't know. Steak and eggs. Is it popular there?
Yeah, there's also a very popular restaurant there called Steak and Ale, which I almost said. Steak and eggs. But I'm sorry, I said steak and potatoes.
Steak and potatoes.
Maybe that's,
that's the first thing that occurred to me.
I'm sorry.
Well, listen, you've got $500. You have another shot at it in game number two, but right now this for you.
Steak and eggs.
Here we go.
Yeah,
welcome
right.
Sherry Karma's back here and ask her to choose A or B.
I'll choose B.
B it is for her. which says, Jack said my paycheck is so small, spent it all in a blank. My paycheck is so small, once I spent it all in a blank.
All right.
Here we go. Jack said my paycheck is so small, once I spent it all in a blank.
In a candy machine.
In a candy machine. All right.
That's good.
A vending machine. What do you say?
I spent mine all in the same place where my fan club holds its weekly meetings, in a phone booth.
In a phone booth.
Now, I will explain to you briefly. If you had said on a, I would have said spend it on, so small, I spent it all on a midget, a little play on words. But you said in a, so you said there wasn't a difference. There is a difference, but I didn't say that anyway. I said laundromat because I'm heavily into laundry.
All
I'm
right, Charles.
I'm heavily into cleaning. You want my answer? Yeah.
No, not that I'd think of. I said a 10-cent pay toilet.
The whole paycheck. Paycheck is so small, I spent it all in a what, Janelle?
I thought of someplace not... in a thrifty.
In a thrifty?
Yes.
Oddball. She's an oddball. Gotta give her that. What do you say?
Cute. I still am one of the few people in America whose checks are so small they can cash them on the bus.
On the bus. Right. What do you got, Deborah Lee?
I said a McDonald's.
Yay! A McDonald's. All right.
All right.
$1.98,
huh?
For your round one question, we have...
Jaboyga.
Hey, have you heard about the new television show?
No! Oh, wow. Not his!
Hey, what is it?
It's a new television show for fat people, and it's called Love Blank.
What is this?
All right, Ralph. This new television show for fat people, it's called Love Blank.
A lot of good answers. I'll say Love Boat.
Love Boat?
Love Tub?
Boat?
No. See, we said it's for fat people.
Right.
Did he say boat?
And they need a boat.
He said boat.
There is a show called that.
Ask him a question.
Yeah.
You mind your own
business. Ask him a question.
Ralph, do I understand correctly that you are a college professor, sir? Now, you're into rocks, a geologist. I don't mean to be facetious, but I just wondered.
I'm not a professor, no.
Ah. But you are a college graduate?
Uh-huh.
Man, there's an IQ of a houseplant.
Go, Bill.
We came close. We right. I said love bloat.
Love bloat.
See, I don't think he heard the question.
All right.
What do I
know? Well, I had love bloat, but I liked his answer so much I stole it. Love bloat.
All right.
Love bloat.
Love bloat is the answer.
He liked both our answers.
Right. Excellent. Go ahead, Janelle.
Love bloat.
That seems to be the response, right, McLean?
Yes, I was really defending Ralph. I have the feeling that he did not clearly understand the question. Did you, Rockhead? Did you understand what he was saying?
I got it.
Cannot believe. Bloat.
Bloat. Five bloats so far. But remember, Deborah Lee marches to the sound of a different drummer.
Well, this could be.
I said, you're right, I do. I said love blubber.
Love blubber.
The thought was there.
Oh, Ralph.
All right. We'll go to round two, and since the score is tied and she went first last time, you go first this time.
Great.
Weird Wilma is really weird.
How weird is she?
She's mourning the loss of her boyfriend, so she's wearing her blank at half mast.
The show, you know?
All right, here we go, Ralph. Weird Wilma is really weird. She's mourning the loss of her boyfriend, so she's wearing her blank at half mast.
Dress?
Her dress. There's one guy in the audience who wears a dress who says, yeah! All right, Bill.
At half mast, I said her panties.
Well, of course, anything like that.
No, you see, first I said pantyhose, I threw that out. Then I said bra, I threw that up. And then I realized half...
mast.
Mast and half girdle.
Aha!
Get it?
What is it?
Ready, Chuck? Go.
Will Bess Meyerson please call the studio as soon as possible?
Oh, Miami, good job.
Her chastity belt.
Her chastity belt at half mast.
You could have said what you said.
All right, Jonelle.
I really don't want to give my aunt.
She's wearing her
stockings.
Her stockings at half mast.
They should know.
What nifty answer have you got, McLean?
I put down for a nifty answer. Pants.
Her pants. A good one. What have you got?
It wasn't my first thought, but I said bra.
Her bra. All right.
Black.
You could have said that.
Well, now, Sherry, all you'd have to do is match one and you win the game. Let's see what happens. Mrs. Noah said, "It's tough being married to Noah. It takes him 40 days and 40 nights to blank." 40 days and 40 nights.
Oh, if I can't say this.
Well, you know where our life is at. are you waiting for moi?
Right.
Okay, I'll just...
All right, Sherry. Mrs. Noah said it's tough being married to Noah. It takes him 40 days and 40 nights to blank.
Make love?
To make love. All right.
Janelle.
I refuse to editorialize with this bunch up here, but I said make love.
All right, that wins the game. Let the rest of you hold them up. Now listen, Ralph won $500 in the previous day's play. We congratulate you and thank you for being here on Match Game. We're going to send you a bed of nails and a fur ball.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ralph. Now there's a message for you. Here we go. Sherry's won the game, and she's going to have a go at the big money now. You could win over $10,000 here. Good luck to you. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Subway blank. All right. Now, let's see whom you call on here from some assistance.
Hey, we're all New Yorkers.
How about Bill?
Hello. Subway train?
Okay.
You want Janelle, McLean, or Deborah Lee?
I want Janelle.
Subway tokens.
Subway tokens.
Right, and McLean.
Subway station.
Subway station. We have subway station, like subway train, and subway tokens. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I thought of subway station.
All right. That was McLean's answer, right? All right, here we go. Let's see if it's under the $100 response. There's a token. Let's see if we get a station under the next one, please. Station, we get it right there. What do you think is going to be on top?
Train.
All right. Slide the big one. Train it in.
Does she get the plane in there?
Now, you've got $250. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. However, we do want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. Good luck to our $5,000. Here we go. $2,500 with McLean Stevenson. Ready?
It's cheap at half the price.
Here we go. Blank biscuits. You write down an answer to this. Blank biscuits. You have to put it in the slot.
Oh, I'm sorry. I dozed off.
All right, now he's finished, and your job is to match him. If you do, you collect $2,500. What do you say to that? Blank biscuits.
Buttermilk biscuits.
Buttermilk biscuits. I guess the audience is not too thrilled with your answer. What would you say?
Well, the heck with them. Who knows what I said, eh?
That's right. Depends on you, McLean.
I wished I'd have thought of buttermilk. I thought of bacon powder.
Baking powder biscuits, yes.
Corn and bacon powder biscuits?
Corn.
Meatloaf?
Yeah.
Talking to a boy from Midwest, man.
Right.
If I was 22, I thought gravy was a beverage.
It is.
You mean it isn't?
It isn't.
No, I'm kidding. I said dog biscuit.
Dog biscuit. That's a good one. Well, I'm sorry you didn't win more money, but you've got a total of $250 in our best wishes, Sherry Karmas. Now this message for you. I thank you one and all, and I shall look forward to the pleasure of your company on another occasion. This is the end of the week.
Oh.
It's time to go.
I have fun on the weekend.
No tears, please. No tears now. Join us next time for the Match Game. Gene Mayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Bedsack. New ID and bed covering provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses or box springs and protection for new, furnished by Bedsack. An electric trivet and easy meals without skimping on taste begin with Armor Star Ham. Tender, juicy ham, fully cooked and ready to use. Armor Star Ham. A calculator and Deep Woods Ought, the insect repellent that protects against extra-tough mosquitoes and biting flies. A tray and Dentine chewing gum. While you're chewing Dentine, it freshens your breath as effectively as even mouthwash. Brush your breath with Dentine. A supply of quality automotive chemicals from the marketers of popular Quaker State motor oils. You'll be staying on the road with Quaker State. A picnic jug. And for a tasty change of pace, Lemon Tree, the lemonade-flavored drink mix from Lipton. In low-calorie and regular. And a calculator and Raid House and Garden Bug Killer. It kills bugs dead indoors and outdoors, yet won't harm most plants or shrubs. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.